I pour my heart to you in 5 minutes and then we'll be closing. Someone may ask me, but what are you really looking for? I heard Jesus say in John 14:12, if you believe in me, the works that I do shall ye do also, and greater works than these shall ye do. These are no flamboyant statements. They came from his heart. But, short man, what are you looking for? I'm looking forward to seeing an army of members of this church carrying the duplication and multiplication of the grace of God upon my life. Why I live. I want to see it while I'm here. I want to see that while I'm here. I'm looking forward to see men and women continue to manifest this grace openly in their various endeavors. That this same grace moves to your company, moves to your industry, moves into your business, moves to your career. I'm looking to see men and women scaling higher heights than I have ever scaled. I'm waiting to see. I'm eager to see. For? I'm looking forward to seeing men and women sharing greater testimonies of the grace of God than I've ever shared. Let me hear your amen if you're there. If you're sure you're one of them, let me hear your loudest amen. What are you looking for? I'm desperate to see men and women in this commission do the works I do and greater works than grace has given me to do. I'm saying that to mean one thing. Many number ones in the world in their various fields will rise from here. Many that may not have found their feet right now will emerge number one in their feet globally. At an unimaginable speed. What are you looking for? I'm looking towards raw impartation of spiritual gifts on this army of co-laborers. Yeah. So they can be established. Yeah. With the same grace. Yeah. In their journey. Yeah. You will not fail nor falter. Yeah. Ups and downs are over in your life today. Nobody among this army of workers will suffer damn times anymore. You belong to a ministry that is ever advancing. You are on board the flight of a commission that is ever advancing. Your life from today will be forward ever. And backward never. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. What are you looking for? I'm looking forward to seeing a little one among us become a thousand. And a small one, a strong nation. And I'm going to see why I live. I will see these things with my two eyes. A little one among you shall become a thousand. and a small one, a strong nation. Wait. National breadwinners will rise from this church. Kings of the earth will doff their crown at your feet. They will come looking for you in your houses. Because God never lies. God never lies. That's my panting. That's my craving. That's my desperation. Dr. Copeland is here alive. He's saying the grace of prosperity on this life and this commission. Kennedy Hagin is gone. He saw faith in raw manifestations before he left. I must see this. I must see this. I have a covenant with God to see. Many of you will be turned to global celebrities in my life. In my lifetime, many of you will be turned to global celebrities. And so shall it be. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Give the Lord a big time, big hand of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. In conclusion, let nobody confuse you. Why this unending crave for growth? It is the heartbeat of God for the end time. What is it? For it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established on the top of the mountains and shall be established above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. We are in the era of multitudes in the body of Christ. That somebody else has not seen it does not make it an error. This God, our God, wants all men saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth in church. For the church of God is the center of divine illumination. He wants them to come to the knowledge of the truth, not just to be saved. So multitudes are ordained to be flocking to church for divine enlightenment and illumination, so they can enjoy the liberty that redemption offers. And this generation, cities will be emptied into churches. Churches will grow to become kingdoms. Allow this truth to rule your heart. This is not an ambition. No. It's a great commission. What is it? You won't miss out of it. Now, the good news about your life this time is, as you take a territory for Christ, it's empowering to take territories where you belong. Amen. Number one in every field of human endeavor will be located here. Amen. In a short while, it shall become the winner's world. The highest concentration of giants in the history of mankind will come up from here. Rise to your feet, everybody. Is somebody blessed? Give Jesus the biggest clap offering.